I had a high school teacher. It was really weird. I had the first period of the day. He'd come in with his coffee. He'd take a sip, and he'd go, "To you." And it was really weird. I'm not gonna do that. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another video. Today, I'm gonna be going over everything shipping supplies. So I've had a lot of questions, and I mean a lot of questions on where do we get our boxes? Where do we get our little bubble mailers? Where do we get our tape? Where do we get our everything, you know? And then the little stamp that goes on it. Got a little bit of hair sticking out there. Everything about shipping. So I figured, you know what, let's make a whole video on it instead of just doing a Brickside chat where I just answer the same question week after week. So hopefully this video answers everyone's questions. So I wanna start out by showing this off, and this is a little box kind of divider separator thing that I worked on over this past weekend, actually. Today is Sunday, and it's 11 p.m. already, awesome. Anyway, so I literally just installed this about 10 minutes ago, and I kind of worked on it the whole weekend. And you can see it just has multiple dividers, and it holds, you know, the priority mail boxes down there, some other larger boxes, and then kind of our standard shipping supplies on the top shelf up here. And then it's got a little spot for some tape down there, as well as our label printer. And, you know, this is just made out of scrap wood that I had laying around. It's actually made out of, I think it's got four different kinds of wood in it, actually. So it's not perfect, it's not pretty, but it does the job, and it does a pretty good job, actually. So I'm going to start by going over here to our smallest mailer, our smallest bubble mailer, and the smallest packaging option that we have. And, you know, we'll talk about this for a little bit. So this is just a 4x8 padded bubble mailer. We get these, actually, we get both this and this, the two mailers on Amazon. Now, we're looking for different options. We haven't run out in quite a while, so we ordered a few hundred a couple months ago, so now we have, I think that holds about 100 there, so we have 100 of those left. We got like maybe 25. I don't even know if there's that many of those left. So once we run out, we're not gonna continue buying on Amazon, hopefully, because these were $7.99 for a pack of 50 when we bought them. Now they're up, at least the same ones we bought. We could explore other options on Amazon, obviously, but the ones we bought are now, I think they're like $12 or $13. So a little bit too expensive when you only get 50 of them, and obviously they don't need to be blue. I like the blue, but, you know, different options. So this one's for small orders, and by small orders, I mean, you know, maybe a few pieces, or depending on the size, it could be a few hundred pieces potentially, but we don't really like to pack these super full. We try to keep them relatively flat, and then if we need more space, we'll stick it in one of these. Now, I don't always ship minifigs in bubble mailers, especially if there's a ton of multiple minifigs, just because I'm worried there's the potential that they could get crushed. So obviously really small orders, kind of small, medium orders that are pieces. And then if we need more protection, or it's a larger order, or it's all minifigs, we move up to this box here, which is a 4x4 inch box. And, this is from Uline specifically. So if you saw the expansion video last week, or on Friday, I think, you saw that we got 450 boxes. So that was a shipment from Uline. And the reason we did that was because Uline ships, and they charge you for shipping because they ship overnight. You don't have the option to do like ground or anything. You get the stuff the next day. So we figured if we're paying for shipping, let's pay for a lot, or let's get a lot of items so that we're, you know, getting our money's worth of shipping at least. So we got 225 of these, 200 of these, and then 25 of these. So these are the 4x4 inch boxes, and these are the nice little squares that we have. We can't really go smaller than 4 inches, just because the labels are 4 inches wide by 6 inches, so even on this one we have to fold it over one of the edges. But this is probably the most common box we use, and then the second most common is definitely this one. This one is 6x6x4, actually. So that one is, this one we definitely use, sorry, I'm not even focusing on the camera, definitely use this one quite a bit for medium-sized orders. And then we had a problem because the priority mail, they're expensive to ship, and obviously it's a large box, so we didn't really have a step between that one and this one. So last time when we were on Uline, we bought, and we only got 25 of these because we don't need them that often. This, I believe, is, yeah, it's an 8x6x4 there. And again, on uline.com is where we got those. And these are going to be kind of our middleman if we need something in between this size and the priority mail. And then, of course, we got the priority mail bubble mailers, not bubble mailers, boxes. So this is the medium box, and then we have the large flat rate over here. And we don't use the flat rate too often, but we definitely use the medium more often than the large. And these are free at the post office. You don't need to pay for them. You can either pick them up at the post office, or you can go online and you can order them, and they're free and they'll ship them to you. And I think I just ordered, you know, another 25 of those and 50 of these or something. and whatever's not stuck in here, we will stick and kind of store somewhere else. This holds about 100 of these boxes. This holds about 75. This one probably holds 15 or so. Probably 15, maybe 12, 10, something around there. And then we got this little extra compartment here for some tape or whatever. We got some tape back there in there. It's kind of dark, can't really see. I just figured, initially I was gonna put the label printer in here, but I figured if we're standing up here and we gotta reach down for the label printer, why not raise it up a few other inches and get some storage for tape? And then you can see we've got the little label printer section here. I'm still gonna plug it in and hook it up and stuff. And then we have some storage back there on a shelf if we wanna put something back there as well. And that's pretty much kind of our new storage shipping storage section, I guess. And obviously when we pick the orders, we'll pull it and walk over here with it. And then we can pack it in whatever we need down here. It'll be nice. You can just reach down and pull out your envelope and it's all nice and neat. Nothing's gonna be falling apart. A lot of people have been asking the stamp we have on our boxes. Some people have said, do you pay for custom boxes? I know my dad saw it today or the other day or something. He's like, you guys don't pay for that, do you? I was like, no. I was really smart, actually. And I went and bought a stamp. So this is from rubberstamps.com. You can see it's been heavily used. And essentially what you do is you put in your logo or your text or whatever you want, and you just upload it to them, and then they'll actually create the stamp and cut the stamp out for you. And then we just got this stamp pad, and you know, the stamp pad on Amazon, this is rubberstamps.com. And when you stamp it and you know, you get the ink on it and you go stamp your boxes. Obviously it takes time, but I feel like it makes it a little more personal when they open up a package or when they get a package in the mail. They see it says just a brick in the bucket. They pretty much know what it's going to be. And then over here, we also have some the little business cards. Now these aren't great for advertising because they don't actually really say much. They just say just a brick in the bucket, YouTube and Bricklink, and it's really hard to see the YouTube and Bricklink on camera. And on the back it just says thank you. What I do wish for this is that I had a little section that says order number, and I was able to write the order number on each card as we put it in the box. Unfortunately we don't have that, but that's okay. And I don't really have a station for that down here. I thought about scooting this over and building a small box and putting these vertical there. I don't know, it might be another small project when I'm, you know, really not doing a ton. Just to build one down there, but for now this works, and it's in the little box it came in up there. And then these we got from, where did we get these? I think it was Go To Print or something like that. I'll put the link down below where we got those. And we got them because it was like 500 for, I think it was on sale for like $8.95 or something. And then of course they don't tell you that shipping costs 13 bucks or something, but 20 bucks for like 500 of those cards. And they're glossy on the front, with color obviously, and then on the back they're just the standard black and white. But they actually look very nice, and I think it adds when you pull that out of the box as well. And then over here on the left side we have our counting scale. I did a video on this specifically for actually parting out pieces, but we can obviously use it as a regular scale, and we do when we're weighing packages. If we don't know how much they weigh, we toss it on there and we check real quick. Now a lot of other people have been asking where we get our bags. So by bags, they mean, oh, I just ripped the box. They mean these bags here. Dang, that's disappointing. So these are our, these are actually larger. These are the 4x6 bags, but we put pieces in there. And then in here we have, let's see if I rip this box too. There we go. We have the 2x3 bags, and those are definitely the most common bags we use. The 2x3 right there. And these are from Amazon, but they're from Die Rose. Now for the 2x3, they cost, for 1,000 of them, they are $10. It's $9.99, and obviously if you have Prime, you get the free shipping. So for 1,000, it's essentially 1 cent per piece. For the 4x6, I don't remember how much they cost. Obviously they're a significant amount more. And then we also have 3x4 inch bags. And those I think are $11.99 for 1,000 as well. So those are a little bit more than a cent. But they're obviously bigger than the 2x3 inch bags. Now, Richard Glatter, a few weeks ago, recommended a website called gtbag.com. Again, I'll put the link in the description. When we begin to run out of our bags, and obviously we just purchased these, well, a few weeks ago now, but we don't go through a ton of 4x6 bags, so those will last a while. But the 2x3 bags we go through really quickly. But on gtbags.com, they are cheaper to ship, they're cheaper bags to purchase. So the bags only cost, you know, it's like $8 for 1,000 of the 2x3 inch bags. So you save, you know, $2 there. The key with them is they charge for shipping. So if you order enough bags, you do save money because the, you know, the shipping obviously will kind of go up, but the bag price, what you're saving, goes up, and eventually you can actually save money. if you buy a ton of bags. So, you know, what I really need to do is go figure out what bags we continue to need. Obviously, we're going to get more 2x3s. We'll probably order those, you know, in the next couple days. We're out of the 4x3-inch bags or 3x4-inch bags. At least there are extra stock. We have some over in the little the packing station. But what I'll probably do is figure out, you know, how many we need to buy. And I'll probably spend like $100 on bags for the next few months. And then maybe we'll save money that way. If not, we'll just continue going with Amazon. If you guys have different options or different solutions, obviously let me know. I know some sellers get them from Walmart, and they're pretty cheap at Walmart. But I don't know, I don't really know how much cheaper or if they're cheaper when you buy them in a 1,000-pack. Haven't found anything bigger than a 1,000-pack yet. But if you find some, send them over. We use the 2 mil bags personally. And then the only thing we haven't found a place for are these, and these are these small Priority Mail mailers. Now, we've never shipped in one of these before, so, you know, you fold it into a small box, but it really is quite a small box. You know, that's about the size there. And there's actually more room inside of this box, or definitely more room inside of that box, and those are cheaper to ship. This costs like $8 to ship. Those are based on the weight. So, you know, if we were shipping tires, this one might eventually come into play and might be worth it, but we don't ship a ton of tires, or if we do, it's in a big order and we're shipping in one of the big boxes anyway. So I didn't make a spot for these because I think we ordered, 25 of these, or there's probably 25 here maybe, and we haven't sold a single or used a single one. So I'm not exactly entirely sure what to do with those. I might just bring them back to the post office, or we'll see exactly what we're going to do there. But other than that, I think that's most of the shipping questions we had. Boxes from Uline. Check, got those done. Mailers, we get them on Amazon. I showed you guys the stamp. I showed you our little card where we get our poly bag things. I want to say that's it. I'm going to leave links to everything in the description below, obviously, so you guys can check them out. I think that's all I got. So thank you guys so much for watching. You know, I appreciate it. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed, click the subscribe button for more BrickLink content. And we will see you guys in the next video.